Hello and welcome. I'm Dean Susan Gooden of the L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs at Virginia Commonwealth University, and it is indeed my pleasure to welcome you to the virtual commencement for the spring class of 2021. Though the past 14 months have yielded many unexpected changes, there have also been many silver linings. And one of those great silver linings is happening right here today, this virtual commencement ceremony, which provides a great occasion to celebrate your graduation with all of your family and friends near and far. I know we all share in the pride and joy in seeing all of you across the finish line today. This includes 173 individuals earning an undergraduate degree, 43 earning master's degrees, and 36 earning post-baccalaureate certificates, and 5 individuals earning a terminal or doctoral degree from the L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs. A nationally ranked and prominently respected school, ranked number 1 here in the Commonwealth of Virginia, where we fiercely embrace our mission and commitment to excellence in public service. As we celebrate each of your accomplishments, I also have 2 specific asks of each of you. The first, and indeed the most important, is for you to thank those who have encouraged and supported you throughout this entire journey. Always remain thankful of the personal bridges who have carried you along the way, and make sure you take the time to let them know. This includes, of course, your parents, grandparents, spouses, partners, siblings, grandchildren, children, and cherished friends, just to name a few. We celebrate and honor you on your tremendous accomplishments. We also celebrate and honor your unwavering supporters as well. Second, I ask that you pick up the baton and make your mark on the world as an outstanding Wilder School graduate. Pursuing higher education in public affairs, whether it's criminal justice, public administration, public policy, homeland security and emergency planning, or urban and regional planning, a credential in public affairs is meant not for yourself, but for the public. This is a bold choice that also requires bold action. The current challenges of our world have made the importance of government and civil servants abundantly clear. We are confronted by the unequal effects of a public health pandemic, disparities in economic impact, a continued disproportionate burden of risk, and the long history and current incarnation of systemic racism and oppression. In many ways, this can feel daunting. But the glory of public service and the degrees that each of you receive today is that it has armed you with the tools to confront these issues directly, at the micro level, with a focus on direct practice, and at the macro level, with a focus on policy, advocacy, and administration. And so, I am confident that each of you will make your mark, turning our collective challenges into collective action, momentum, practice, and progress. Our society has always relied on public servants to lead the way. And you, as a Wilder School graduate, are at the top of the profession. You will make a difference because public servants always do, no matter the practice area, no matter the setting, and no matter the location. You have a license to problem solve, to represent, to advocate, to be part of a great tradition of civil servants who have confronted the novel and urgent challenges of the day. So I ask you to forcefully pick up that baton, stay true to yourself, and invest in a more just and equitable world. Government, and indeed our society, needs you. Congratulations, Class of 2021 Wilder School graduates. We are exceptionally proud of you, and we have high expectations of you. I now have the honor of introducing our student speakers. Our first student speaker, Stephanie Lau, is a native of Atlanta, Georgia. She is receiving a doctorate of public policy and administration. Stephanie received her bachelor's degree in neuroscience and anthropology from the College of William and Mary, and she holds a master of teaching degree from the Johns Hopkins University School of Education. She currently serves as transition training associate at the VCU Rehabilitation Research and Training Center, where she works to support youth with intellectual and developmental disabilities. Her dissertation examined the impact of professional autonomy and market factors on the care of Medicaid patients with disabilities. Stephanie is the proud mother of two boys, a four-year-old and a one-year-old, and she's an avid crafter of textiles. Stephanie.
Thank you for that introduction, Dean Gooden. Congratulations, class of 2021. Today marks a milestone, not only of our abilities, but also of our determination and perseverance. Today is also a testament to the love, support, and encouragement that has been freely given by our family, our friends, and the faculty and staff of the L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs. When I first started in the doctoral track in public policy and administration, I knew I was embarking on a journey that would require time, dedication, and persistence. And it did take a lot of time to get here. It could have been so easy to just stop at many different points, especially in the last year, but I didn't. And thankfully, my family, my friends, my coworkers, my professors, my mentor, my committee, and my amazing advisor, Dr. Brubaker, didn't give up on me either. If you're watching today, then you too have endured an unprecedented trial and persevered. 2 weeks to flatten the curve turned into months, and then a year. And throughout it all, you sat in virtual classes, endured the transition from Blackboard to Canvas, and possibly amended your IRB and research protocol. We have observed social inequities laid bare by the pandemic, watched the country face a reckoning about systemic racism, and witnessed political unrest many of us probably never imagined would happen here. As much as these events may have been a distraction from your education, if you were like me, these events confirmed your conviction in choosing to pursue a degree from the Wilder School. We are here because we want to take the knowledge and skills we have learned and apply them in the real world to create social change. There is one quote that I find myself turning to over and over when faced with difficulties or the less than beautiful aspects of life. You can hold back from the suffering of the world. You have permission to do so, and it is in accordance with your nature. But perhaps this very holding back is the one suffering that could have been avoided. Now, the irony that I am quoting Kafka for a graduation speech from a school on public and government affairs is not lost to me. But I love the sentiment that there is beauty in the struggle, because if we look away, we will never know what could be, and we will never know how to get there. As we turn our gaze to the future, I know I will take the lessons learned during my time as a student at VCU and go forward with curiosity, compassion, and conviction. Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.
Thank you so much, Stephanie, for those compelling and inspiring words. Our next student speaker is Finley Loving, who is a native of Richmond, Virginia. She is receiving a Bachelor's of Science degree in Homeland Security and Emergency Preparedness with a minor in Sociology. During her academic career at VCU, Finley interned at the Virginia State Police, and she also served as an active member of the professional fraternity, Eta Lambda Sigma. She is a lover of the great outdoors and a passionate martial artist who enjoys studying kickboxing and Muay Thai in her spare time. After graduation, Finley plans to support the national security enterprise through the private sector. Finley.
Thank you, Dean Gooden. As cliche as it may sound, if someone had shared with me as a freshman that I would be here speaking to you, I could not have believed it. Virginia Commonwealth University has truly changed my life. This university has welcomed me with open arms. Whether it be through professors, students, and organizations, VCU pulled me out of my shell in ways I could have scarcely imagined. I was reluctant to come to VCU, not because I didn't want to, but because I was frightened. The very thought of going into a college sent me into a panic. I had been bullied throughout my life, most especially in high school, and these experiences left me with crippling social anxiety. All of this, paired with the deep doubt I had in myself academically, the result of two learning disabilities, meant that I was, in short, a mess. I persevered through my initial campus experience, which consisted of a failed attempt at banter with a fellow student at a campus fair. The student was raising money and recruiting, so I went to speak with him. And as I approached, I was warmly greeted, "Hi, how can I help you?" And with that, I froze, ran into the bathroom, and had a 30-minute long breakdown. Somehow, I didn't back down from the internal challenges I was facing. I knew that I needed and wanted a healthy college experience. Persistent in these efforts, I joined Eta Lambda Sigma, a professional fraternity for students pursuing a career in homeland security and emergency preparedness. At Eta Lambda Sigma, I was given the guidance and support that I needed in order to grow and truly discover myself. Through time, my confidence also grew. I became more comfortable and was even able to apply to internships, become the social event lead for the fraternity, and develop lifelong friends along the way, some of which include faculty. And I share this all not to congratulate myself, but rather as a testament to the three words that guided me throughout my college experience: perseverance, persistence, and pleasure. Perseverance, because the only consistent thing in life is change. And many of these changes are impossible to predict, like this pandemic, for example. Despite this challenge, each of us stepped into the ring to confront this uncertainty. We all knew it would be hard, but we also knew that we could do it, even in our weakest moments. Second, persistence. And through this, we grow. Here, we learn how to tackle even the most impossible of tasks. Armed with our spite towards the challenges we face, we don't give up. Instead, we reassess and change our plans. Finally, pleasure, which is where we are now. Having stepped into the ring, we emerge having fought the good fight. We may have taken a couple punches along the way and stumbled on the occasion that things did not go as planned, but today, we rise victorious with our diplomas. Today is the moment that we reflect on the challenges we've overcome, appreciate the lessons we've learned, and cherish the instruction we've received as we continue onward into a world of uncertainty. I implore you to remember these words, as they've allowed me to grow from a girl crying in a bathroom to an author of a book, a world champion boxer, a VCU alumni, and today, your commencement speaker. Take a moment to reflect on what you have already achieved, because what lies ahead will be more remarkable than what you can imagine. Take chances, because we only have one life to live, and it's on each of us to make it real.
Thank you so much, Finley. It is now my great honor and privilege to welcome our commencement speaker, the Honorable L. Douglas Wilder. Governor Wilder is the 66th governor of Virginia and a distinguished professor at the school that bears his name. His career in public service spans over 50 years and includes many historic milestones. He is the first elected African-American governor in the United States of America. Governor Wilder served from 1990 to 1994. During his tenure, he was twice commended for his sound fiscal management and balancing the state budget during difficult economic times by Financial World magazine. Prior to his historic term as governor, he served as lieutenant governor from 1986 to 1990 and as a state senator from 1969 to 1985. His legislative achievements are numerous, including providing state health care coverage for sickle cell anemia patients, toughening penalties for capital murderers and prison escapees, and expanding low and moderate income housing. For 8 years, he persisted in sponsoring legislation that eventually led to establishing a state holiday honoring Dr. Martin Luther King, Jr., making Virginia the first state in the nation to have a legislative holiday for Dr. King. Persuaded to run for mayor in 2004, Governor Wilder received 80% of the vote and carried each of the Richmond's 9 council districts and every precinct in the city. He was sworn in as Richmond's first elected mayor in 2005 and served until 2009, making him the first African-American mayor elected by popular vote from all of the citizens of Richmond. An attorney by profession, Governor Wilder gained recognition as a leading criminal trial lawyer. He graduated from Howard University Law School in 1959 and later established the legal firm that became known as Wilder, Gregory & Associates, one of the few minority-owned businesses in Virginia at the time. Prior to earning his JD, he graduated from Virginia Union University with a BS degree in chemistry and worked in the office of the chief medical examiner as a toxicology technician. Governor Wilder has served as a distinguished professor at VCU, where he lectures and hosts symposia, including the most recent, Race in Academia. He is the recipient of more than 36 honorary degrees, including the NAACP Spingarn Medal, the Anna Eleanor Roosevelt Medallion of Honor, the SCLC Drum Major of Justice Award, and the Thurgood Marshall Award of Excellence. Please join me in welcoming our Spring 2021 Commencement Speaker, the Honorable Governor L. Douglas Wilder.
Thank you, Dean Gooden, and let me say how pleased and proud I am to be here today as we celebrate the graduation of the class of 2021. The undergraduate speakers and the graduate speaker have done so much to inspire those of you as well as me to know that which we are committed to, that you can say that you earned your degrees from a nationally ranked school and the highest ranked school in Virginia is mind-blowing. The issues confronting us as a nation have never changed. The solutions are and have. And that is our job, not yours alone, to go forth and change the world. No, go forth and let the world listen to you as you suggest the changes. They've never changed the issues, education, employment, jobs, health care. That's never changed. We must know the history of our nation and its people, and we must demand the same for those of us who are in leadership. No one is sacrosanct, no one should be spared. Our communities must reorganize. The profiteers and self-promoters must be removed or voted out. Our commitment is to real and fundamental education, not piecemeal. We must determine what we want and be unrelenting. Our resolve is to identify it and to remove everything relative to racism and race. Does it exist? Yes, we do know. One of the things we are doing at this school is to try to meet those problems head on by educating people here to address those problems in our communities. But it must be to real and fundamental educational reform. It must be unrelenting. We don't need any more conversations about anything. We need results. And if we don't do the job of eradicating the problem, then we must have those persons who say they are our leaders removed. You'll be called a troublemaker. I know a little bit about that. I was called that and have been called that. And, you know, I still might be called that in some places. But I've loved making that kind of trouble that resolved the problems, that resolved the issues, and that identified with the people. And through our leaders of our state have said that I couldn't go to schools in Virginia, not the schools that they went to. There were those who provided opportunities for me to finally be able to get an education. And I did that. And that no one stop you from that resolve, and let no one tell you that the job is over. So I ask you to make your commitment to the people of America. I want you to understand that you can do that. You can be whatever you choose to be, and you can be whatever you want to be. No one sets out to be governor as a child. I didn't. I wanted to be successful in whatever. But to the extent that I was the first African-American governor elected in this nation, didn't make me too happy till I saw that there might be a second and there might be others. It's not a question of race, it's a question of reality. The current events now let us know and show us who real leaders are. You must always demand what is right and criticize what is wrong, and let no one tell you that you can't, let anyone tell you that you can't succeed, because in the absence of that filling of the gap, and filling the vacuum, we'll have more of what is going on today. And I know I speak for all of you when you say, and we say, enough is enough, but what do we put in place that's real and substantive and demanding and is of and for and by the people. You are the people. Go forth and show that. God bless you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Governor Wilder, for those inspiring remarks and for all that you have done for our students, for our faculty and staff to lead by example, not to mention the Commonwealth of Virginia, the nation, and indeed the world. And now for the moment we've all been waiting for. As Dean of the nationally ranked L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs, I am delighted to present our candidates for the Doctor of Philosophy in Public Administration and Public Policy. These exceptional students have fulfilled all requirements and are recommended by our esteemed faculty to pursue their ambitions to become the public service scholars and administrators our world needs right now. Please stand by for the names of our graduates and their much-deserved moment in the spotlight.
William Farley, Ryan Kelly, Stephanie Lau, Benjamin Platch, Nathan Teclamariam.
As Dean of the nationally ranked L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs, I am delighted to present our master's degree candidates and post-baccalaureate certificates, including criminal justice, homeland security and emergency preparedness, public administration, and urban and regional planning. These exceptional students have fulfilled all requirements and are recommended by our outstanding faculty.
Cyan Myers, Colin Vaughn, Kayla White, Megan Williamson, Erica Blackson, Kevin Shivatanan, Madison Frady, Taylor Loomis, Alexis Montalvo, Caitlin Vaught, Lauren Wallace, Kemper Wills, Sydney Wright, Tristan Aiken, Caroline Blake, Matthew Critchley, Spencer Graves, Robert Halloran Jr., Warren Mays, Summer Morris, Kaylee Pickenpaw, Tabrielle Roberts, Megan Robertson, Amanda Sylvester, Hillary Small, Matthew Wibley, Shadi Zaid,
Rebecca Ackland,
Logan Ashby, Aaron Berryhill,
Ashley Catterton,
Rebecca Cesaris, Chesley DeLeon, Leah Demarest, Margaret Gallagher, William Gillette,
Chad Kingstrom.
Jane Houck.
Nicholas Jenkatis.
Daniel Mota. Michael Nixon Garrison.
Gabriela Pino Moreno.
Amelie Reeves. Grace Stankus. Olivia Allison. Richard Foote. Justin Patterson. Joseph Pickert. Amanda Thompson. Randy Tran. Takesha Bell. Marta Bonner. Nora Elliott. Angelica Galich. Cinnamon Langley. Gabrielle Marquise. Eloise Martinek. Lydia Orr. Bethany Peel. Leanne Ragland. Courtney Reese. Destiny Spain. Jeremy Winslow. Sarah Worthy.
Jessica Slater Banks.
Jenny Chelmel. Melissa Suzuki. Alexis Cosby. Katherine Johnson.
Christopher Jones.
Kira Molinaro. Adrian Robertson. Cody Simonetz. Christopher Stone. Heather King.
As Dean of the nationally ranked L. Douglas Wilder School of Government and Public Affairs, I am delighted to present our candidates for all bachelor's degrees, including criminal justice, homeland security and emergency preparedness, and urban and regional studies. These exceptional students have fulfilled all requirements and are recommended by our outstanding faculty.
Amalia Agnew. Natalia Aguilera. Sami Ahmed. Sahira Akhtar. Reem Ali. Salah Almuwais. Muhammad Al-Sobail. Nawaf Al-Subay. Diana Argueta Mendoza. Emily Arnold. Jessica Arsment. Genesis Banks. Masco Barrett IV. Talia Bomert. Madeline Bean. Shaylee Bowling. Christopher Boyer. Andrew Brooks. Lauren Burke, Kira Byers, Matthew Byram, Julia Carmardella, Darian Carpenter, Mectis Charles, Taylor Charles, Tanya Chavez Alonso, Aaron Coleman, Kayla Cook, Amandria Cooper, Bridget Crowley, Philip Delcor, Hudson Dizan, Kendall Dolan, Aaron Donahue, Jenna Downing, Devin Dunn, Tania Easter, Abigail Emmerich, Olivia Ernest, Nihat Espinoza, Katie Flam, Brittany Flintosh, Adam Forbes,
Kyle Forbes,
Chloe Forrester, Brooke Gilbert, Julio Gonzalez, Brianna Gordon, Juan Guerrero, Iana Guy, Susana Harris, Selena Hernandez, Daniela Hidalgo, Adrian Nguyen, Jessica Nguyen, Brianna Johnson, Amber Jones, Alan Lamb, Ariana Ligoris, Jasmine Lewis, John Lugo, Qatar Machui, Bruce Martinez, Jaron Mayo, Destiny McDonald, Anna McDonald, Cassandra McGill, Alex Mills, Kennedy Mills Watson, Maria Montes, Christy Morris, Sarah Mosher, Colin Muldoon, An Nguyen, Shorte Oliver, Eleanor Outlaw, Catherine Pearson,
Dana Porter,
Bradley Post, Andrew Pugeli, Sierra Rector, Kristen Robinson, Samantha Rokoff, Kamisha Rory, Sophie Sharp, Ariana Scholar, Kristen Sierra, Caitlin Summers, Courtney Talley, Amia Totten, Sama Tufik, Jacina Tower, Raina Towns, Lorena Torrett Gill, Carl Villarreal, Mackenzie Weaver, Brianna Wadle, Maria Whitehead, Genova Williams, Zakia Woodley, Alyssa Wooten, Asia Yaber, Alexandra Zeta, Ahmed Al-Azri, Abubakar Alawi, Mahmoud Al-Kalhali, Najim Al-Khalafi, Patrice Branch, James Borello Hood, Tyler Butterworth, Omar Campos, Madison Casanova, Fatima Chavez Pineda,
Destiny Cologne,
Christopher Diana, Maya Diallo, Laura Ehrmantraut, Kevin Elliott, Sierra Fox, Matthew Gallick, Sophia Gonzalez Alvarez, Bianca Gonzalez Cruz, Riley Gore, David Hansen, Lauren Holtzclaw, Mason Nguyen, Kyle Kimmel, Sophia Kingsbury, Ashley Kirkpatrick, Casey Craker, Mara Lee Landrum, Finley Loving, Rebecca Lowe, Claire McKnight, Kristen Martinez Lemus, Caleb Meyer, Brent Miller, Fabian Miranda Pagan, Hanvi Patel, Logan Phillips, Gerald Reynolds, Ruben Rodriguez, Samantha Sika, Christian Spurgeon, Andrew Suzales, Lauren Wallace, Joseph Wardlaw, Daniel Webster, Marquise Wooten, Zena Zachary, Yitany Baranyi, Tyrone Boyce, Heather Buckley, Ethan Bushing, Nina Chenoweth, Tessa Demarest, Tariq Fayad, Mariel Hankerson, Garrett Hug, Kennedy Johnson, Syed Kamal, Ariana McCoy, Brandon Morton, Taylor Narn, Nathan Oblin, Carol Ann Peddle, Chloe Pollard, Nadja Shiza,
Ashley Taylor,
Nathaniel Vogel, Faith Walker, Michael Weaver, Meredith Wheeler,
Michaela Wildman,
Zion Richardson, Nicholas Yetka.
At this time, the Wilder School would like to recognize the recipients of graduate degrees and post-baccalaureate certificates that will be awarded in August of 2021. Helen McDonald, Cameron Blatt, Riley McLean Dandridge, Andres Garces, Devon Gordon, Abigail Heath, William Smith II.
Thank you to our student speakers, Stephanie Lau and Finley Loving, to our commencement speaker, Governor Wilder, for his words of wisdom and his extraordinary legacy and commitment to public service. Thank you to our esteemed faculty and staff, and to the friends and family of our graduates who are watching today. Most importantly and most deservedly, congratulations to our class of 2021 graduates.